Welcome back. So in the last session, we have dealt with informal measures of database design, right? Now we introduce a formal tool for analysis of relational schemas. So we will measure the quality or goodness of a relational schema design using a formal tool. So the single most important concept in relational schema design theory is that of functional dependencies. So in this session, we will try to formally define the concept of functional dependency. And in this session, we will see how this concept can be used to define normal forms for relational schemas. So what are actually functional dependencies? So they are constraints that are derived from the meaning and interrelationships of the data attributes. And they are used to specify formal measures of the goodness of relational design. They are actually constraints between two sets of attributes. Okay. So now let us try to define it formally. And suppose our relational database schema has n attributes a1, a2, etc., an, and the schema is denoted by capital R. Now, a set of attributes x functionally determines a set of attributes y if the value of x determines a unique value for y. So that is denoted by x to y. X functionally determines y. So it's actually defined between two sets of attributes x and y, where x and y are subsets of the entire database schema R. And this functional dependency actually specifies a constraints on the possible tuples. So when we populate this schema with different instances, values, right? So for any two tuples, this functional dependency must hold, that constraints must hold. So if we say that x functionally determines y, then if we take an instance of this R, okay, when we populate this schema with values and R is the extension for R, then any two tuples t1 and t2 in this R, what happens? The constraint should hold. That means if t1 of x is equal to t2 of x, that means the x attribute set of two tuples t1 and t2 are the same, then they must also have the same value for their y attribute set. That is what you mean by this functional dependency. Now let's see some examples. So in the company database itself, we have the employee relation, right? So in that, the social security number determines employee name, right? You can say such a constraint there. That means, so we can denote it as SSN functionally determines E name. That means for any two tuples in that employee relation, if the SSN is same for those two tuples, then definitely the employee name also should be the same, right? So there's a constraint between SSN and the employee name. Like that, project number determines project name and location, right? So if two tuples in the project relation, if the project number is the same, then they must surely have the same project name and project location. So that's also a functional dependency that we can denote as P number functionally determines the combination of project name and project location, right? So employee SSN and project number determines the hours per week that the employee works on the project. So in the left side, hand side also can have a attribute set instead of a single attribute. For example, in case of a project, the combination of what SSN and project number together determines hours per week. So any two tuples, if the combination of SSN and project number is the same, then the hours per week should be same. That can be denoted as SSN project number. That combination functionally determines hours. So we can say that A functional dependency is a property of the attributes in the schema R. So whatever values we are populating in the schema, that is whatever instance small r we have, this functional dependency must hold for any two pair of tuples in this relation. Okay. So, and in specifically we can say that if k is a key of r, k is a key means k will be unique for any tuple, right? In that case, we can say that k functionally determines all attributes in R. That means if two tuples have the same value for k, definitely all other attributes also should have the same value, right? Because the key k is unique always. And let us just go through this extension of our company database or populated data. So we can say that SSN determines all other attributes because SSN is the key value for an employee relation, right? So SSN determines e name, SSN determines birth date, SSN determines address, SSN determines department number. For any two tuples in this employee relation, if SSN is the same, then other attributes also should be the same, right? Like that, we can have different constraints on different relations. Now, if functional dependency is actually a property of the entire relation schema, right? Not just for the current instance. That means we cannot infer some functional dependency by seeing just the contents of the current instance. Okay. So we should define explicitly those constraints by analyzing the meaning of these different attributes, not by just seeing the current content of this database schema. Okay. Just for example, suppose we don't have this entry. The second tuple was not there. By seeing this example, we may say that teacher functionally determines course. If the teacher is same, course also should be the same. But here is a counter example, right? The same teacher having the same different courses. So there is no such a functional dependency. But what about text to course? If the text is same, course also should be the same, right? So we may infer that text to course, such a functional dependency is the text functionally determines course. That hold for this current instance, right? But we are not sure whether the same functional dependency may hold for all instance of this relational schema. So we can say that one cannot determine which FDs hold and which do not until the meaning and relationship among attributes are clearly known. All one can say is that certain FD may hold, okay, by analyzing the current instance, current state of the corresponding schema, we can say that certain FD may exist. So here also we can say that the text to course, such a functional dependency may exist, okay. And we cannot guarantee its existence until the meaning of the corresponding attribute is clearly understood. Anyway, one can surely say one thing, that by analyzing the content, certain FDs does not hold. That we can clearly say if the corresponding FD is not held in the current instance. Just for example, here we can say that there is no functional dependency between teacher and course. Okay. From teacher to course, there is no functional dependency because we have a counterexample here itself. So for any instance, we are sure about such a constraint. There is no functional dependency between teacher to course, but this may hold. That's only that. So we can say that text functionally determines course. Such a functional dependency may exist in this relational schema. And teacher functionally determines course. There is no such functional dependency in the schema because we have a counterexample here itself, right? For the same teacher, we have different courses. So there is no such functional dependency. We are sure about that. And what about the course to text? There is no functional dependency because we having the same course data structure here, we have different textbook, right? So such a functional dependency also do not exist in this scheme. So we can conclude like this. Thus, functional dependencies are derived from the meaning of the attributes and relationship between different attributes. Okay, and FT is a property that should hold for the entire schema, not just for an instance. And given the instance of a relation, all we can conclude is that an FT may exist between certain attributes. And we can definitely conclude, given an instance, that certain FTs do not exist. Even a single counterexample is enough to conclude that certain functional dependencies do not hold. But to ensure that an FT exists, a single instance is not enough, right? Let us take another example. We have given a relation schema R with attributes A, B, C, and D. Current extension is like this. We have four different tuples. Okay. So let us try to infer some functional dependencies analyzing this contents. Okay. What about the functional dependency A to B? A functional determines B. Let us take the two tuples with having the same value for A. First two tuples, right? They are having different values for B. So there is no functional dependency from A to B that we are sure about, right? What about B to A? Two tuples having B values same, but they are having different values for A, right? So there is no functional dependency from B to A also. What about D to C? Two tuples having the same value for D3, right? They are having different values for C. So there is no such functional dependency from D to C. So we are sure about these three different functional dependency. They are not there. Okay. Now what about B to C? B functionally determines C. If they are having the same value for B, they are having the same value for C also, right? So in this certain extension, we can say that this functional dependency hold. B functionally determines C. So it may hold for the entire relation schema. Here it hold. For the entire relation schema, it may hold. There's a chance. And what about C functionally determines B? If they are having the same value for C, they are having the same value for B also, right? So that functional dependency also may exist for the entire schema. Now what about combination of A and B to C? If any two tuple having the same combination for A and B, A1, B1, we don't have such a tuple, right? So we can say that here everything is unique, such a combination is unique. So we can say that such a functional dependency may exist if any two tuple having the same value for A and B, then the C also may have the same value. So such a dependency also may exist in this relational schema. Now let us see how this functional dependency can be diagrammatically represented. So in our employee department relation schema, the SSN determines employee name, SSN determines birth date, SSN determines address, SSN determines department number. And the department number determines department name, and department number functionally determines department manager SSN. So these are the different functional constraints in the case of employee department. Like that employee project, we have SSN and project number together functionally determines hours per week, and SSN determines employee name. Project number determines project name. Project number functionally determines project location. So these are the functional dependencies in the case of employee project relation. So this is how we can represent any functional dependency. So next session we can see how this functional dependencies can be used for normalization. Thank you.